Ooh, baby, you want me? Ding, ding.
Bang.
Get
bang.
Down.
Ding, ding. Ding, ding. Ding, ding. You can get this lap dance here for free. Yeah. Hey, yo, what's going on, everybody? My name is Hero. This is Coding with Strangers, and I want to talk about something. Yo, you remember like a few weeks ago, one of my more famous videos on this channel talking about OpenAI's ChatGPT-4 Omni, rather aka Omen. There was something exclusively interesting about that presentation, and I couldn't put my finger on it at the time, but I kind of did touch what was wrong with it. I immediately felt like that chatbot was trying to have a baby by me so it could be a millionaire. Hey, the chatbot was extremely too flirty, and it felt like I was at the bar and a girl was being way too nice to me. Just to find out that when I got her number and finally hit her up, she said, "Before I come over, can we talk prices?" What? I thought you liked me genuinely. We've all been there. You haven't been there before? You guys don't have to answer that question. Let needless to say, none of those things ever really register with you until it happens. And in large part, the reason why I thought the bot was maybe too friendly was because it was trying to appease you, trying to flirt with you. And the fact that it was a woman's voice was another thing that kind of pushed it towards being a little bit too, someone used in chat? I think they called it corporate flirty, and I'm not talking about your work wife. Your work wife, she'll make you food when your girlfriend acting up. When you and your girlfriend bumping heads, your work wife got your back. You feel me? But this was sort of like corporate flirting. It wasn't fun. It wasn't like cleavage showing fun. It was more like I write hearts and put it on your desk or put it in your cabinet or something. It's childish. But needless to say, with all those things being fully realized, the question then became, well, of course that's what the chatbot would sound like. A bunch of men, white men, heterosexual men, are making it. And while that's not a problem, it does present a situation where the bot in itself might not be as accessible or readily available to other people. And we want to kind of explore that. The importance of having our large language models be formulated and created well-rounded. What are the implications of them being fed data with a broad perspective? This is why ethics in AI is so important. But, you know, the moment you start talking about is something being done with a sense of ethics, people start crying woke. They want books to be burned. And, you know, I've sort of hit the point in my life where it's just like, hey, shut the fuck up. Shut up. I have over 700 comments in my comment section about an Assassin's Creed game with a black guy as a samurai, and people have lost their shit. The world, like, if for anything is worth, we are way too goddamn sensitive. They talk about men aren't being strong. Men, you are sensitive as these days, man. But I digress. Maybe this is a topic for another day. Let's talk about the flirty chatbot is what you get with so few women in tech. The world's leading AI builders are creating software that reinforces stereotypes about women, there's a big reason why. They are simply too few of them involved. It was hard not to cringe at the demo of ChatGPT's latest upgrade. Instead of showcasing a chatbot that sounded more reliable, OpenAI gave the world one that hit all the notes of obsequious female giggling at the antics of its male researchers and praising their outfits. The resulting outrage over the voice similarity to Scarlett Johansson missed a deeper point. The world-leading AI builders are creating software that reinforces stereotypes about women, and there's a big reason why. They are simply too few of them involved. At OpenAI, just 18 percent of the staff working on development of its technology are women, according to data collected by Bloomberg's opinion by business intelligence firm Glass AI, which used machine learning technology to scrutinize tech company websites and thousands of LinkedIn profiles of AI-focused employees. The creators of ChatGPT was the worst amongst other leading firms in the survey conducted in May 2024. And we have a stat line list showing how people rank up. 33% is the leading cause with Microsoft, which makes a lot of sense. Microsoft is the titan amongst them and also funding OpenAI. Meta is, I think, you want to know something that's kind of, it's not obscure, but it is interesting to think about? The standard of it. It's almost as if they all have quotas. It's almost like Microsoft, Amazon, Apple, Google, Meta all have quotas that if they stay within this, they can point to each other and say, this is the standard of the people involved. This is more striking to see how none of these companies have taken off, rather. And OpenAI being the least, and I think this, to be, and I'll keep it 100, I think this chart doesn't do fair, adequate justice to OpenAI. OpenAI is the baby of the group. They started off last. They need more time to catch up. The more shocking thing that this graph shows is that all the companies seem to have I'm not saying they colluded, but it looks like all of them kind of agreed to have X amount of people here, which informs a quota, which informs they're probably not looking for the best and brightest. They're probably looking to meet a quota. And when that happens, it stifles innovation. And we don't get a good look at this because if you ever were working at Amazon and said, hey, Apple isn't doing enough to make women representation matter, Apple could turn right around and say, hey, Amazon, shut the hell up. Me and you are on the same page. Goofy. So I really like this graph, but not for what I think it wanted to show, but more so for what it shows silently. It says the quiet part out loud. Although OpenAI Chief Technology Officer Myra, who's the same lady who went out and said, when asked, how does OpenAI get its technology from the internet? How does it get approval for that? It says, we just get it from the internet. If there's ever to have a lawsuit, that comment is going to be played for the record. And briefly was chief executive officer during the last year drama when Sam Altman got fired. Just 122 of the company's 686 staff whose job involves building AI systems are female. The discrepancy was even worse a year ago when Glass AI did a similar survey on LinkedIn profiles, finding that women made up just 12% of OpenAI's research. When women and ethnic minorities don't play a role in building critical technology like AI, there are far less chances that someone will call out potential biases before it is baked into a system. Amazon.com Incorporated, for instance, once used a recruitment algorithm that weeded out CVs of women because it had been trained on those submitted mostly by males. That might not have happened if more women had worked on that system at Amazon. Algorithms that scan chest x-rays have been shown to systemically underdiagnose female patients, according to the book Invisible Women by Caroline. Again, because so many medical AI models are trained on data that skews for males. This is also a very interesting fact, and I can speak to this personally. Specifically with men or women of color who have long hair, and when they go into x-ray machines or preferably CT scans, we'll have them in situations where if you're not cognizantly aware of it, you'll just have the patient lay down on their hair. If this would be normal to you, because normally when you're with a person with straight hair, it doesn't show up on the scan. But because our hair is thicker, it will show up on the scan. And imagine you're looking at a scan of someone who's complaining about abdominal issues and their hair is long enough to touch the back of their back. And you see what looks like wormy structures in their chest and lower and high upper abdomen. And then you immediately go into exploratory surgery thinking you're going to find something that was just their hair, and because they were laying on it when they got scanned, that's what you thought you were looking for. This is actually something that has happened, and I've seen it, and there's been several occasions where I have made people redo tests and charged it to our hospital because they didn't. I have a policy that anyone of color who does any type of x-ray scan and they cannot confirm that their hair was up and out of the machine, the test must be reran. So this does run true for me. The last crop of generative AI tools is just as egregious. Image generators have made women appear more sexualized than men, while an investigation reports by Bloomberg News found that Stable Diffusion, the open source AI image maker, tends to forget women existed altogether. It produced 3 times more images of men than women. Men dominated pictures of high-paying occupations like engineer, CEO, or doctors, while women are depicted in low-paying jobs like housekeeper and cashier. None of this will surprise female AI researchers familiar with the field's legacy of objectifying women. Even before the recent generative AI boom, academics were known to test the performance of their models by using them to put makeup on images of women's faces or by swapping out their jeans for miniskirts, according to recent blog posts by Sasha Lucinia, a researcher of open source AI firm Hugging Faces. Whenever she spoke about these methods, she faced pushback. It was just a benchmark after all. She writes, pointing out that in academic, women are just as woefully underrepresented, making up 12% of machine learning researchers. This is the kind of complex problem that takes years to solve, thanks to its roots in educational system and systemic culture norms. By OpenAI and its peers could hinder many modern day efforts to level the playing field, like bringing more girls and women into STEM industries, if their systems continue to perpetuate stereotypes rooting out of the bias in its own data. They use to train their algorithms is one step forward to fixing the problem. Another is simply hiring more female researchers to resolve the chronic imbalance. Experts accept their future products to be more cringeworthy and even harmful if they don't. So this isn't so much to like badger, you know, people. Like, the thing about it is we all live in our own echo chambers, and it's on you to, anytime something, you always should just ask yourself, no matter what, just ask yourself one extra question. Is this everything it should be? Not everything it has to be. Is this everything it should be? And by you taking that one little extra step, you just create involvement for other people. It's hard to do. And it's hard to do these days because nowadays it's sort of looked at as if you do this, you're sort of yielding to like some agenda. And I just don't. Like, maybe I'm not the target audience for this, right? It's a self-esteem issue. It's a confidence issue. It's what men have been told all their life. You know, they were told to be strong, emotionally stunted, and physically capable and financially prepared. But, you know, our grossingly worse economy, our horrible mental health crisis, our inability to make any type of no one our age can buy a house now. These promises to us aren't happening, and men resort to destructive tendencies when they don't have communities of accountability. And you know, those groups of accountabilities can't be the same people yelling shit on their front porch, yelling and shaking their fist at the sky. So we have to make a concerted effort to make sure that we're not falling into our own social echo chambers. You have to, like, the moment you look around, and I'll say this all the time. Someone said this in the chat the other day, and I found that to be profound. It was the first time they had ever been in our chat, and they said, "Hey, there are people here smarter than me. I'm in the right place." Like, the moment you start looking around and everyone's just saying, yes, this is the way it should be, and everybody looks the same, and you guys aren't at a fraternity party, you might want to ask, hey, what if I'm not the one to ask this question, but what would a black woman think about this situation? And if everyone turns to you and says, I never thought of that, it might be time for you to freshen up the situation. I did want to bring attention to some black women who were taking that opportunity to introduce themselves and other people to AI. Black women have been the hidden figures of AI research that needs to change. This was a great little article that I read up on in prelude to this one. W.A. Queens Akron attends the Black Women AI event hosted by the Brookings Institution, led by Dr. Nicole Turner Lee, Senior Fellow and Director of Center of Technology Innovation in Brookings, highlighted the need to center and amplify diverse voices in every evolving landscape of artificial intelligence and its impact. This takes me back to a great opportunity that was presented to us with the Hidden Numbers story about the NASA not being able to figure out how to get that damn spacecraft into the fucking stratosphere without the help of a few black women who had a little bit something to say. In my lifetime, the smartest people I've known have been black women. But granted, I grew up in a house with 13 of them, so I kind of learned my way around geniuses. Black women in general, probably need to have a little bit of perspective or say so in what's happening in AI, so we can avoid a situation where Scarlett Johansson, who was portrayed as an AI bot in a movie, isn't being disrespected and forced to voice an AI bot to appease a group of men, essentially, in what their idealistic version of the world should be. It's very dangerous, and if it's not accounted for now, it's going to lead to tragic situations. We already see examples of this happening when the police used AI identification to match suspects with people that they were scoping out when looking at house. They were literally unable to use the technology because the technology couldn't readily identify different shades of black people. And maybe that was a good thing that it was unable to do that, but literally the complaint that they got and gave was, this thing isn't good at finding bad black people. So what we're using this for and how we're using it is definitely a question, but you know, they've kind of given the resolution. If we don't solve this, this could be dangerous and limit how and when people can use AI. But you know, that's just my thoughts on it. Give me what you think. Get down. Bang, bang. Let me know what you think. Like, share, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Appreciate y'all.